What's going on, everybody? How's the what's the deal? What's the deal, man? What's your deal? Really, huh? It'd be like that sometimes. Alright, I'm gonna leak proprietary code. Nobody, don't tell nobody about my proprietary code. Let's go! What's up, Vinificus Dukes? How's it going? I'm coding. Don't tell anybody. This is proprietary code. I'm breaking the law by leaking my proprietary code. Probably. I don't know. Alright. What do I gotta figure out next? Oh yeah, music. Let's do music. How does synthwave sound? This is some brain music. Very real tired AF, same. Actually, I was way more tired earlier today, I have no idea why, but at like 1:30, I just collapsed and practically slept for an hour. It was so weird, because I usually don't sleep in the middle of the day. And I had a full night of sleep. Actually, I think I don't know. I'll check. Check my sleep tracker. Alright, well, that's gonna take a little bit. Okay. So. We can get every Pokemon and their moves. Once we have those, we need to convert them to data values. That's pretty simple. We actually already have them all split up and everything. Yeah, they should be exact matches as well. So, exit the loop. Just had an extra break because... oh yeah, let's do my sleep. Nope, still loading. Okay. Oh, I need an array. I need to store all these. Let's just do... data? That's annoying, but... oh well. Who cares? This is my stuff. I can name it whatever I want. Wait. Did I name that wrong? Zeros. Shape. What do we need? 5 data values for 6 Pokemon. We should also grab opponent's data, but maybe we can do that later. Yeah, so 6 Pokemon, 5 data values. That works. And store them first. We have I, yeah, I 0. Wait, that just stores the... will that work? I can probably override it. I don't know all the rules of Python. Easy way to program the AI, always use the move with the highest base power. Yeah, but I want it to win, is the thing. I want it to be able to win some battles, at least. Honestly, if you can beat me 50% of the time, it's good enough. Or even, like, 1 in 10, honestly, at this point. Yeah, I had a pretty average sleep last night. Pretty typical. Slightly below average REM. Slightly above average deep sleep. Actually says it, I got really bad sleep last night. So I'll try not to do that. But that is a way to win battles. Maybe like 1 in 50. I feel like there's a lot of cases where you're just going to end up using like a normal type move into a ghost type. Or something of the sort. For Mon in... I should not use the same name, should I? Actually, doesn't matter. For Mon in Data... do the Pokemon first. I actually already have the code that does that. Which is right here. I'm gonna have to enumerate, isn't it? Isn't I? Ain't I? I'm hoping it by default resets these values. I'm gonna have to enumerate this as well. Data I 0 kits J. Wait, I have to start at 1. How do I do that? Start equals 1. Start. Just so I don't end up with a 0. Divided by the length of mons. There we go. Now that should do every Pokemon. We can do. I should probably copy this. Do a similar thing for. Actually, we can put these in the same loop. Same super loop, anyway. Is that correct terminology? I have no idea. Is there a way to do this more efficiently? You know what? I'm just gonna fucking... I'm gonna do it inefficiently. I don't care. Doing it efficiently would be too complicated for no real goal or no real benefit. Someone might look at this and be mad, if you've ever coded in Python before, but like, it's just how it is, man. I'm just gonna code like a Neanderthal. Okay, there's definitely more efficient ways to do this, but this should work, at least. I'm commenting, though. That's a thing programmers do, right? That is how we beat all the gym leaders. Use the highest base power move. That is one way to do it, probably. I don't code. It's okay. You're better off. Is there any way to convert find closest partial match? Uses like a specific sequence measure. I don't know what this does. I literally just pulled it from ChatGPT, which means it's probably stolen, but I don't really care. This is a personal project. I'm gonna get sued. Okay, after converting them all to values, then I'm trying to remember how coding works. Then we, not coding, the project. Do I need to store those? I guess I probably need to store those. Need to convert them to a full array. It's a float. Oh. Let's use data and then vals separately. And I'll use vals to store the value. So I'm not overriding everything. Because I think I'm gonna need the data for later. I need to at least store the moves of each of the Pokemon on my side. I guess let's see if this works. I'm gonna just set up a mock game though. Hello? There we go. Okay. So I have this little match. And now we're just gonna run this, and it should grab all the data and convert it to values. We'll see how this goes. Unless I did something really wrong. Oh. Could not convert string to float. Oh, I forgot there are Pokemon with less moves. Oh no. That's such a wrench in my plan. Everything's so hard-coded. This is actually terrible. Alright, well, that's a problem for another day, actually. How do I make an array of strings? String? STR? Oh, it's STR. Gonna fuck up on Ditto. Scowl snap, Sneep. Okay. It did not store anything correctly. I can't believe I don't know how to do an array. Back to ChatGPT we go. Actually, it could just be lists. Okay, apparently it just wants me to use lists. Wait, I should already have the capability to make lists of varying sizes. Would it be plagiarism if I had ChatGPT write in my entire textbook for me? Yes, probably. You'd probably get in trouble because it'd probably rip stuff off. Gosh dang it. It's supposed to be a list of lists. Wait. It's one list. How do I. Maybe there's more efficient ways to do this. There's definitely more efficient ways to do this. Yeah, okay. I'm gonna revert some stuff. This is definitely the more efficient way to do this. Loops within loops, man. Solid is just loops within. I don't know why it does that. I do know why it does that. It's just annoying though. Okay. Now that is all meaningless. Okay, prove to me that vowels can be done correctly. That's what I really want to see right now. Doop. Okay. We got some. Still a lot of zeros, though. Like a shocking amount of zeros. Oh! Well, you see, it's because I overwrote the same variable 8 times. That's cool. Oh, it's gonna find the closest. Okay. So ditto causes a lot of problems for this. That's interesting. I'm gonna reset. Do a new battle. Because this should work flawlessly without ditto being in the mix. I'm gonna need some sort of ditto safety clause though. I think that should be correct. Should be roughly in alphabetical order. S is after Q. Three and four are relatively close together. Yeah. Looks right. Psychic. Those aren't alphabetically sorted. Maybe I should sort them alphabetically. My moves file. Anyway, we do a list of size 6. I think that's how that works. I think you can preset list sizes in Python. I hope. What do I do? Store it as a tuple? I don't know why people say tuple. I just said it right now and it feels really, really wrong. Okay, now need to print data, and we'll see Everything's running properly. This assignment index out of range. How is it out of range of 6? Oh, it's a list with one value. I need to do what I was doing before. This is a list of length 6. List of empty lists. Wait, is it? In any case, hopefully this works. Okay, it looks to be working. Alright, so we got Volcanion with Earth Power, Steam Eruption, Flamethrower, Sludge Bomb. Correct. Quillfish with Spikes, Waterfall, Gunk Shot, Taunt. Yep. Sneasler, Close Combat, Dire Claw, U-Turn, Night Slash. Sableye with Knock Off, Taunt, Recover, Will-O-Wisp. Caesar with U-Turn, Close Combat, Bullet Punch, and Defog. And Iron Valiant with Calm Mind, Moonblast, Close Combat, and Psychic. Maybe I should do more testing with Ditto. I'm kind of worried about what could happen with Ditto. Oh well. That's a problem for another day. You know, I just need this to work enough so that I can show it off for a video. That's really all I'm after, is a good-ass YouTube video. So I could fake the whole thing, but that would be lame. I'd rather have actual code to show to prove that I'm actually doing something for real. What can I use for long-term storage? I guess I could just have it return. And each battle has a... What's the game state going to be stored as? I guess we go with a list of lists. What all do I need from the game state? It's like HP. Changes to HP can be done mid battle? No. I feel like there's no way. What happens if you click a move? I need to remember what shows up in chat. Shift gear. It does tell you the amount of health lost. So I guess reading the chat would probably be my best bet. What does it need to know? Just needs to store moves, Pokemon, their positioning, and the opponent's Pokemon and HP, which I don't have access to, so by default they're going to be blank. This is complicated. I'm realizing this is a lot more complicated than I guess I expected. Okay, so I have all this as lists. Oops. I have all this data. Needs to get returned. I forget how to return something. Oh, right, arrow. Do, 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 do. Return. What is it? What will it be? A tuple? I guess it could be a tuple. A list. A list of lists. Well, at the very least, I could read the opponent's Pokemon. Do I want to read all of them? Dang, this is like crazy complicated. I can't believe I'm just realizing. This music's not helping. It's in my head. Let's go find something whack.
What if you could do SEO smarter?
What if? I wish I knew how to just read off the... screen. Wait, can you press buttons with Pyota GUI? Hold on. Your keys? Okay, so I can just copy the text and then read that in. I forgot this song is horror. Okay, how can copying be helpful? I need to figure out a way to specifically find the points where the text is going to be for each turn. I don't know how to get all of it, but I can control C and control V. I don't know how to get that into the program though. This is shockingly easy. Now the only problem is locating the latest turn. I could take images of all of these. Or I could just start, let's say here. Drag down to here. Control C. Import the text. Okay. I know how to import the text, and then I guess that just lets me read the game state. What happens if a few turns are over? I gotta figure this out. I wanna see how it scrolls so I can make sure that this isn't gonna, like, fuck up immediately. Thunderbolt. Ooh, good damage. Taking a lot of damage from that flamethrower, though. I have the speed advantage. I'm gonna go ahead and roost. Oh no, Kilowatt 12 fainted. Bro. Go, Toxtricity. I'm gonna shift gear while you flamethrower. Okay, so if a lot of things happen on a turn, I think it should still be visible on screen, and I should still be able to get it by, like, clicking at some point up here and then dragging all the way down to here. Is there any point where it would scroll up accidentally? What is this? Talking heads once in a lifetime. Interesting. Okay, well, all this text follows format, such as ending with exclamation points and such. So that should be easy to parse. Okay. Let me use this little bit to find the relative location. Hopefully this doesn't fuck it up. Where did I put it? I gotta hide this. I don't know what's on my stuff. This is such a weird song. Oh, wait, it goes from user to users. Well, at least I'm catching these bugs before we try to get the code to work. Okay. That should work, whether it's user or users. What am I listening to now? Oh. This is 8 minutes long. Anyway, pretty sure it's art. I'm just gonna do tuple. Cause I think I need both of them. Did y'all hear that? Pretty sure this song is supposed to turn into horror. Okay, it's about to turn into horror reel. This is supposed to be... Rotting meat? Human skin? What's happening? String. String is not a thing. It's a stir. They're creative. Is that... That's an off by a... That's really annoying. That's a useful comment. Guys, I'm scared. What about my skin? Guys. Why is this such a horror show? I feel like otherwise it's not gonna work. Okay, should be able to locate the file. Or not the file, the image. Let's just make sure that it's giving something back. 717-138. I feel like that's right. I think I'm just gonna trust that. Okay, so can we start from there? No, that gets weird. This song is so scary. Okay, we need it. Plus, is that 15? 20? 15? It is usually Y137, right? That's what it spat back, 138. Okay, this is a way different vibe. Could I do 12, I wonder? I'm wondering now. Thank you, Kanye. 150 works. I'm gonna do plus 12. And minus. /60 /717 -647 That is 60. No, 70. So 70 and 12. So we need to offset by. That's good. Wait, no, subtract 70. Position 2. Add 12. Kanye. I can't believe he would say that. I gotta check if I can click and drag. I think I read something on the wiki about being able to. Half click is a thing. Okay, move to. Oh, drag. Okay, so I move to the first position, then I use dot drag to button left. I'm just gonna copy that because that would be useful. I should have checked. Oh well. Just write some of this and then I'll fix it. Move to. Control C for copy. What is this song? It sounds too sad. Next. Bubblegum Bitch sung by Jay Schlatt. Sounds awesome. How's AI doing? It's doing. Okay, so it looks like X 1900. So I could add 1250? Yeah. 1250 to X. What is it, 150? 1030 minus 150. $880. I think. That sounds right. And what did I need to import that text? I needed... need to install clipboard. Let's just see if I can just import it raw. Probably not. Okay. To see if all this nonsense works.
By Poseidon's name.
Clipboard.
How is this possible?
I'm about to go. Okay. I don't think drag to worked, unless I'm misunderstanding how it functions. Down should work. I hope. Let's try it. Also, I feel like clipboard.paste didn't work. Wait, no. That was the last thing I copied. Never mind. Clipboard paste worked. Oh, hey! Okay. And I'll add an extra click afterwards, so that just to get rid of the visual. One more time. Oh, did you see that? It copied the text off the screen, baby. Oh my gosh. That's magical. And then it should be pretty easy to just parse that text. So I just grab whatever I need. Sorry I haven't been able to show this every time. I just need the Pokemon game on screen so that I can actually run it. Or at least the stuff that I'm working on now. Data. So I get the text when this thing runs. Anyway. Then from there, I need to simply sort through the data. See what I can find. Almost passed an int. How does this work? I forgot how to pass things. Wait. I think I did it backwards. Yeah. Turn of type int. So we find the turn number. It has a string, which will be turn space plus. Convert the int to string. Is this another one of those horror songs? Oh no, this is just Feel Good by Gorillaz.
Never.
Okay, so the string starts with the turn indication that we're looking for. That should be pretty easy. Turn plus one, because it should be on screen, will be the ending. So we do another slice. Actually, I don't know why I wouldn't just do this on one line. It's a long line, but that's fine. That's just how it is sometimes. Sometimes you get long lines. Now within that, I could split it up by lines and then search each line individually, because I think only individual lines tell individual pieces of data about the game. So I can do that. So data dot splits on a new line. One line in lines. If some form of text in line, then you take some action. Okay, what kind of information are we looking for? Used, because used means a move was used. That's an important piece of data, right? Is it? No, I don't think that it's stored. At least not what the opponent used. And you should already know what you use, because you're the one who picks it. So, use is important. However, losing health is important. If health in line? What is that? Oh, that was just the outro. Okay. Okay. So if some health change happens, what the hell is Jay Schlatt singing now? How bad can I be? Jesus. There's so many Jay Schlatt AI covers now, and they have crazy amount of views, honestly. Posing. Okay, we want it to start after this string. So we're gonna find that, add the length of it. Oh, wait. Some Pokemon have spaces in their name. That's fun. That means it's gonna be slightly harder. I think we're looking for the first space, it's lowercase.
Don't worry, King Charles, you're next, buddy. Keep music videos going while you
watch. I think Jay Schlatt just made a legally admissible threat on King Charles's life. What the hell is this? Has 36 million views. Can't be that bad. It looks kind of bad though. Like, just the art style on it is worrying. I guess we'll just listen to it and find out. Are there any Pokemon with three-word names? I guess I have a list of the Pokemon, don't I? There's a fair number of them that are hyphenated, but there's also ones with spaces in them, right? Like Iron Hands? Yeah, all of the iron ones. So I need to find lowercase. But I don't think there's more than one, so if poke.find, find the first space, plus one of poke, so the next character is capital. Wait, cancel this. How to check the case of a character in Python. Let's see what GPT has for me. Is upper. Ah, that makes sense. Okay. I have to slice it an extra time. I guess we'll just use underscore. No, I shouldn't do that. Key. after the space. Everything after the space. Wait, no, it has to include the space. Wait, no. Okay, can't include the space in this, but I have to include the space in the final product, so. Hard-coded space. This is probably so bad. Oh well. So it ends at the next space, so this should find whatever Pokemon there is. Okay, so we should have found the Pokemon. Wait, I don't have to do... This is not that complicated. It follows such a strong pattern. I'm an idiot. All this is unnecessary. Space lost. I do. Okay, it's fixed. It's okay. It's all right, everyone. This is gone. Back together. And I'm never going down at the hands of the likes of you because I'm so much better. And every part of me is saying go. Kind of this is a big remix. Alphanumeric. There's an alphanumeric check. That's pretty cool. Python has a lot of stuff built in. This is really a mega mix. There's already, like, at least two songs in here. It's a 3x mashup. Just the two of us, stronger than you, and harder, better, faster, stronger. Anyway. This is certainly interesting. There's something kind of annoying about just, like, string parsing. I'll just find the percent of character. That's easy. So it ends at the percent character, which should give us a number. Potentially a float. So lost gets float. Converted lost. And then, I don't know, I guess this should convert the data. I'm kind of tired though. I'll be honest, I don't know that I can do this for much longer. I am just going to pack it up for the night, y'all. Yeah, this has been fun though. I might do more coding streams. Pretty chill. Pretty sick, I think. I'll see y'all, though. Tomorrow. Most likely. Oh, there's a direct at 10 a.m. tomorrow. Shoot. I kind of want to stream during that. I might stream the direct. I don't know. We'll see. Alright. Bye, y'all. See you tomorrow. Probably.